Hi guys, today we are going to look at parsing action in SLR1. What is parsing action means? Your program, user written program, we all, you and me, tend to write a C program so that our program is termed as input to the parser. For example, we tend to use ID plus ID or ID star ID for the purpose of evaluation. We normally give some expression. This is meant for operator precedence or operator evaluation statements. This parser, whatever we are discussing, is meant for operator. So that only we are having some expression in the form of evaluation. So let us consider the expression ID star ID. This is what the input string. ID plus ID stands for input string to the parser. Input string to the parser is termed as ID star ID. Now, with this, what we supposed to do? We already have come across LL1 parser, parse table, parsing action as well. Similarly, parsing action is going to become same like LL1 only. We need to create a column called stack. The operations of stack we are discussing here. Input buffer. The input needs to be loaded into the buffer. That is input buffer column. Action is for our understanding. Every time what I am doing, that I will be writing here. This is for human understanding. That's all. Internally, there is a stack operation, input buffer, and this table and the parsing algorithm. Four component. This parse table is the predominant input, and the stack is a hardware or the medium, memory reservoir. Input buffer is a hardware. So this table is a kind of reference table. There is a program called SLR1 parsing algorithm. That algorithm will control this parsing table, the stack operation, input buffer. That is what the schematic diagram we have seen in the beginning of the discussion. Now, what are you supposed to do? You need to, all the time, stack need to be loaded as a first symbol dollar. Without any other thought process, you need to load dollar. This is the first step. So initially nothing will be there, stack would be empty. You need to push the symbol called dollar. What is zero? You may ask question. This zero is my state number. I started marking here zero. If you would have marked one, that is your wish. You can start with one. However, the mother state, rather I can say the mother state number. This is a state number I am using zero, so that state number I am pushing it onto the stack. So this is your initial configuration. Initial configuration of the state is of the stack is pushing special symbol called dollar and pushing starting state of the DFA. That's all. This is what your initial configuration, nothing more. Understand this initially. Similarly, what we are going to load into input buffer. We are trying to load the input string ID star ID. We must end up with dollar. So dollar dollar match only indicates acceptance of the given input string parsing. That is the reason we must end up with dollar in this case. So this is the initial set. Guys, do you have any doubt in it? We are pushing dollar onto the stack and initial state or mother state number. Similarly, we are loading input buffer. We are ending up with dollar symbol. This is your initial configuration. No more duty. If you understand this, let us proceed further. If you have question, you can clarify. If not, let me proceed. Now, your prime duty is to look at top of the stack symbol. This would become bottom symbol. This would become your top of the stack symbol. And the left extreme of the input buffer is ID. This is what under scanning. See, this ID is under scanning. I have put this 0 is your topmost symbol. So now we need to take a pair 0 and ID. We need to look at the parser table. What it is telling, we need to take the action. That's all. You need to pair 0 and ID. Go to the state 0. Look at the column ID. This dictates shift 5 operation. Row number 0, column identity ID, both together dictates us to do shift 5 operation. So shift 5. That is what the action we are going to do. What is the meaning of shift 5 is I need to shift the ID symbol to the stack. I need to write down followed by 5. So let me write dollar ID is shifted. I need to write 5. So this is what my input or symbol or content of the stack. Look at now input buffer. There is a loss of information. This is shifted to the stack. So that the remaining content would be star ID dollar. Now what is your duty? You need to look at this pair. 5 is the row, star is a column. You need to look at this pair. 5 and star, you need to make a pair and look at what it says. Let us see. 5 and star. Go to the row 5. Look at the column star. It says us to do the action reduce 6. Let me write reduce 6. What that signifies? Reduce 6 means go to the production. That number, production number, reduce 6. Reduce 6 is F produces ID. This I need to use for reduction action. So that I am writing in a bracket this. So this one is not at all required. This is the reduce action. So this reduce action, the moment it says F produces ID, I need to reduce this ID by F. That is the significance. Look at this. 0 produces ID. 0 produces ID. You need to retain this 0, the initial state. Here I need to write 0. Okay. That 0 is remains constant. Now 5. And star, I need to look at 5 and star. It says dictates us reduce by 6. Sixth production is F producers ID. So that I am bringing here. So I need to one symbol. If you miss also, parsing action will not happen. That is why 0 I am pushing back. 0. Now this ID need to be replaced by F. Because it says whatever is on the top of the stack need to be replaced by F. ID by F. Now what number you can write, you will ask question. No number for reduce action. Shift only you need to write the number. Now input buffer will be remains the same. Now what I supposed to do, your question. Now one action you have learned, shift action. Next is reduce action. This is different action. Every stage is a learning. Listen carefully. Now you can't make a pair F and star because you don't have F row. You have star column, that is fine. There is no F row. In this circumstance, what you supposed to do is, you supposed to do 0 and F pair. Look at, this is what you are going to look at, 0 and F pair. Go to the row 0, F, what it says is 3. So that you need to write down 3 here. You need to write down 3 here. How this 3 has come? Look at carefully. 0 and F. Whenever the combination, let me remove this. Whenever the combination non-terminal and terminal comes into the scenario, non-terminal, there is no row. Star, you have column. By that situation, you need to scan. You need to go further into the stack. F is the top of the symbol. You need to pop it out. And you need to look at what is the top of the stack. Then you need to make a pair. You need to pop this F, then top of the symbol would become 0. Then you can make a pair 0 and F. We have such a combination. 0 and F combination. By the time, after getting to know the number, you need to push that F back to the stack. Then you need to write down that number. This is the action you need to do. Now, this is set to be, I need to write down go to 3. This is the action I have taken. Go to 3 action I have taken. So that I am writing 3 here. Now, what should become your duty? Now, I am going to remove. Now, you need to make a pair 3 and star. 3 should become your row. Star should become your column. Let us go here. 3 is the row. Star is the column. It says us, dictates us to do R4. 3 and star. So that I am writing here R4. Reduce 4. What is the meaning? Reduce 4 is. Now this F need to be reduced by the production. What is the fourth production? Let me go and refer. The fourth production is T produces F. That is what my production. Now F needs to be replaced by T. This is what it says. Now I need to replace by T. Already we have top of the stack F. Now that F is going to be replaced. $0 remains the same. That F is replaced by T, input buffer will become the same. Nothing else will be changed. Now what I supposed to do is the question. Now you need to look at top of the stack is capital T and input buffer symbol to be scanned is star. There is no such a pair. T is not at all available in the row. In that circumstances, the same procedure like this. You need to pop that T symbol. Then you need to look at the top of the stack is 0. 0 and star, you need to make a pair. Go here. 0 and star. What happened? Error is coming. 0 and star. 3F. Yeah, sorry. T produces 3. 1 minute. Zero T. I need to look at 0 and T, not star. See, I asked you to pop no, then you need to look at 0 and T. Yeah, I only got confused. See, 0 and T. So that 0 and T symbol, we need to load 2. 2 is loaded. How I am doing this 2 is like this F only. 0 and F I looked at. Look at 0 and pair. 0 and F. What was there? 3. So that only I have written 3. Similarly, 0 and T, what was there? 2. 0 and T was 2. So that I patched 2. Now you can make a pair between 2 and star. 2 is a row number. 0 is a column identity. 2 star. 2 and star dictates to do shift 7. So that I need to go for shift 7. First, let me write shift 7. What is the meaning is $0T star needs to be shifted onto the stack followed by need to write the 7. That's all. Now the remaining symbols in the input buffer would become ID dollar. Now this is what my combination. Now what I supposed to do? Top of the stack is 7 and input symbol need to be scan this ID. I need to look at the pair 7 and ID. Go to the row 7. 7 and ID says, see, look at the column. 7 and ID says S5, shift 5. Let me write down this. Shift 5. Look at shift 5. Yeah, till then it is correct. Shift 5. So that I'm shifting this to the stack and I need to write down 5. Shifting the action means ID. The remaining would become dollar. Then I need to write 5. I started shifting the symbol ID. Then I started writing 5 and dollar. Now I need to make a pair. 5 and dollar. This is the topmost content of the stack. And this dollar is the only left out input symbol. So 5 and dollar. Fifth row, dollar column. Fifth row. Dollar column says reduce 6. It is asking me to do reduce 6. Then the same only will come. Already I did it so that I don't want to walk through. Reduce 6. so that remaining it becomes until the star, then I need to write reduce 6 means I need to write F. ID is replaced by F. Look at this. ID is replaced by F. The content of the input buffer would become dollar. It remains the same. Now we need to go for further combination. Guys, do you have any doubts so far now? Reduce 6. T2. After T2, we have come to 7. After 7, T star F is available. After T star F, we reduced by this. Now we need to look at 0 and T. Guys, do you have any doubts so far now? Parsing action. There are 3 different actions only coming. Reduce action, go to action, shift action. Every time we need to take different decision. Shift means we need to push the symbol, write the number. Reduce means it is different. We need to reduce left hand side symbol, not terminal. Then go to means the number beside, before left side of the non-terminal and the non-terminal, we need to look at a pair. For that pair, what it is dictating, we need to write down. If you have got doubt, you can clarify. T star F, T star F has come. Now we need to look at the remaining portion. T star F is the reduce action. If you have any doubt, you can clarify. We have reached up to this. See, this is different method, stack and symbols. I am doing in different method, stack input and input buffer. So until then, 275, we reached 275. Then $5 you need to look at. Then it says to reduce by T produces T star F. This is the production. Reduce by this. Reduce 6 again. So after reduction, you will be having $0 T star F. T star F you will be having. Then you need to reduce by T, then you need to go for accepting stage. Do you have got doubts, guys? Now we need to move on to LALR one parser. This is a parsing action. If you wish to see a kind of operation, I'll take you to this website. I need to stop share. Okay, let it be. So at the end of the session, I will show this. Link I will give you here in the chat window. You can make use of this for referring. It is a kind of a web application developed for parsing action. For every parser, you can give the suitable input. It will show you this parsing action, the complete parsing action, what we are discussing. This table, it is signifying, it is showing you. So this is the beauty of this parser, SLR of one, LL parser, which we have seen in the second unit, and LR one parser. It's a great web application developed by some of the gentlemen. So this is a web application shows you different parsing action so that you can practice more number of problems or more number of the moment I change, instead of ID star ID, if I change by ID plus ID, I need to do from the beginning. Similarly, you can do several problems. ID plus ID star ID you can do. ID star plus ID star ID also you can do. So these are all the combination. The moment input is changing, the entire stack operation parsing action would become different. So for that, you can make use of these links. Now let us go for LALR one parser. Why LALR one parser? We need to go with the reason for LALR one parser is at time you will have the lengthy table. This lengthy table need to be reduced. What I can suggest is, even you cannot understand what I am trying to tell with the support of LALR parser one, after CLR of one, you will understand why we are moving to the different strategy or paradigm of parsing. Our main focus is to reduce the length of the table. What is the length of the table is, look at, there are 11 rows are available. Now we are stepping into how we can improve the speed of this parser. How this parsing speed can be improved, how we can reduce the length of the table. That is for the main objective. For that, LALR one parser is helpful. Much more powerful way is CLR of one. The moment we step into CLR of canonical LR, you can understand the speed of the execution or improvement. Now let us see what and how we are going to look at. This is a given production. This is augmented production. The given productions are, let me write down, S producers, capital C. Look at the first production, capital CC, two symbol. Next production is C producers, small c, capital C. The next production is C producers D. These are all the three productions. Given the CFG, I am writing down. Our primary duty here also, what is the difference? There is no much difference. We'll be having second component. Look at the kernel, or this is called canonical set. Canonical set dot operator is also available. We will be having second component. What is this second component? I will shortly introduce, nothing to worry. For that, we need to start with one augmented grammar. So now I am going with augmented grammar. For the augmented grammar, S dash producers S. So this is the only new production I am doing. So this augmented grammar is ready. Now I need to number as usual, because reduce action we need to do with the number. So after augmented grammar, I am doing the numbering. So these are all the two steps. Till now, it is common to both SLR parser, LALR parser. Look at, this is a given CFG. I started numbering. Then I started using augmented grammar. In the augmented grammar, I introduced new symbol S dash. And the producers, we need to write the starting symbol. Given the grammar, starting symbol is S, so that I have written. S producers CC, C producers small c, capital C, C producers D. Now this is ready. What would be our second step? We need to go for canonical set computation. That canonical set computation, I do only one step. Later on, we can look at the diagram. Now, look at this column. Give me a minute. Now what I supposed to do? S dash producers S. I need to use dot operator as usual. What is the way we discussed? The same dot operator may not be noticeable. So look at, I'm going to give in different color, dot operator. This dot operator is kept before that S. Here I have kept dot operator. Dot followed by non-terminal. Because of the non-terminal, I need to bring the production associated or attached with S. This is the only one production associated or attached with S. After bringing that production, I need to include the dot operator. Now dot followed by non-terminal. Because of that non-terminal, I need to bring all the productions associated with that capital C, dot followed by capital C, so that. Then after bringing all the production, I need to place this dot operator, dot followed by terminal. It is C, terminal means dead end. So that no more operation I am expected to do. Next, dot followed by ID, no more operation I am expected to do. So this is the condition called mother state or the first state we did. So now what is the state number I can give for this? I can give I naught as usual. We used to give I naught for the mother state. So you can stick to the same symbol I naught. Let it be. Now what you supposed to do is your question. Before this, we supposed to compute first for all the given symbol S dash, S and C. That is the primary step before even going to I naught. Let us look into that. 1 minute. First computation. So for this, I am copying the symbol to whom we are going to do first is S dash S and C. So this is not required, no titling, so that this will move. Now look at this production. First of S dash, we are going to do first of S dash, then let me put. This is the column we are going to do first, computation of first. This is the column we are returning the symbol as such. The symbols are S dash, S and capital C. Only there are two production, but symbol is only one. So that I have collected all. Now we need to compute first of S dash. Look at first of S dash is capital S. Nothing I can do. It is non-terminal. So I need to look at the production. Yes, first of capital S is capital C. So I can't do anything. I need to look at. So first of this is C and D. So I need to write down first is C and D. Everywhere C and D only will come, because look at S dash is S. Then S comes C. C, S is dependent on C. C becomes CD. So that one shot I write down the first computation. First of S dash would become C and D. First of S would become C and D. If you have got doubt, you can clarify. If not, let me proceed. So this is called first computation. First is required. Then what else I supposed to do is your question. So the canonical set, whenever you are trying to compute, this is called canonical set table. You need to go for second component. Right now, newly I am going to introduce a concept, second component. So this is what new concept in LALR. What is the second component is, for the augmented production, I need to include dollar. This is augmented production, comma I need to put, second component dollar. Look at here, dollar. Next, what I supposed to do, S dash dollar is ready. Then next step, we need to go for canonical set zero computation. Every production, we need to include this second component. How we are going to include the second component is a part of discussion here. See, S dash dollar, next dot CS. If you look at this combination, in which what is the first included? Dollar is included. So because of this dollar, we are deriving this production. Because of the derivation dot CC, we need to include the dollar. Second component, dollar. Next production is C produces dot small c capital C. Now first of C we need to include, so that CD. It has come from S. This C we have reached from S. Similarly, this C also we have reached from S. So that we are doing CD. CRD would become your first symbol. See, this is the first production. A special production, or we can say augmented grammar. For that, it is a new component. There is no other component available. In the original grammar, there is no such production. So that only we are including second component dollar. Because of this newly included symbol, we are including dollar. Always you need to remember, this is a thumb rule. For the augmented production, we need to include dollar. Augmented production, we need to include second component as dollar. That's all. This is the thumb rule we need to remember. So second component dollar, after that, this C has come from this S. So that we are including dollar. Next. This production we have derived from the augmented grammar. Because of that only you are including dollar. So otherwise we need to include first computation, whatever it is included the first. Next, this C has come from this C. So that now we can include first of the C production. Just now we have computed first of C is C, D. You may ask question, first of S is C, D. First of S dash is C comma D. We have computed, but whenever we are going for second component computation for the dollar symbol, for when we will include the dollar symbol is only for augmented grammar. This is augmented grammar. The second component we need to include dollar. This production we have reached or we have derived from this production, so that we need to include dollar. Similarly, next production, it has come from this dot C. Because of the dot C, we are having this production, so that now we have the freedom to look at the computation of first CD. Similarly, this C also we have reached from S, so that the second component can become C or D. What is available? We need to write down C or D, or you can write C comma D also. This is what we are looking at, the lookup table. Only for the augmented production, we need to include dollar. Because of the dollar, we have taken this S component from this dot S. So that dot CC, second component we are retaining as such. Next step, this C production has come because of this. So because of non-augmented production, now we are flexible to include second component as CD or first of that production. This is what state number I naught or the canonical set I zero we are doing. This is the first step. If you have got doubt, you can question. If not, I'm ready to move with second step. So everywhere we are doing canonical step computation or canonical set computation. After the canonical set computation, we need to go for kernel computation. After kernel, we can go for table. This is the table, final table. See, look at this. The number of states would become lesser. Then parsing action. Given the grammar, augmented production, then first computation. Then we are going for closure computation or canonical set. From the canonical set, we are going for state numbering or state. Then after state numbering, we are going for table, LALR table. The same steps, but only the change is second component, inclusion of the second component would become different. That second component, the moment we are including second component, what is the advantage you may question? Whenever we are doing this canonical set component, it all will be merged. See, CRD dollar. CRD dollar. If the first component is same, only the second component is different, those states are merged together. Because of that merging, you will not have many states. It will be reduced. Finally, you will have instead of 1 minute, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 states. Instead of 10 states, you will end up with only 4 states. Only the first component they will look at, if the moment it becomes same, they will be putting it together. See, C or T or dollar. S produces C, C dot, comma, dollar. Whenever it is common, they are merging. C or D or dollar, all are merged together. This is the advantage of reducing the states. Whenever these are all empty, those empty states are merged already. Because of that merging, the parser table would become smaller. For this same, you can try with SLR 1 also. Given the grammar, you can try SLR of 1. If you try SLR of 1, you can identify the number of states. Then you can try with LALR of 1. So how drastically it is reducing the size of the table, you can able to understand practically only. Theoretically, I started in the beginning, the core purpose of LALR1 is increase the reduce the time complexity or increase the speed of the execution. For that, only the way is reduction of the table. Because lookup time is what? That pair combination, algorithm will take lot of time to look up the entries. We the human being, easily we can able to trace quickly. But algorithm, it would take a lot of time for looking up the pair, row and column. in order to speed up only we are reducing. Again, the purpose of CLR is also reducing the size of the table, lookup table or parsing table. That the moment parsing table is reduced, the speed of execution is increased. So far now, we have seen I naught, how I did is, I started the augmented production, I placed the dot, I started including the second component after the dollar. That second component, I have computed first, I agree. But here when you come, this is a procedure. So why first I have computed is, whenever we are in the position to look at the first component, we no need to do by the time. So the tabulated, all the things are tabulated, nothing more I did. Now, this dot yes, dot followed by non-terminal. Because of that non-terminal, I am bringing the production associated with that. S produces CC. Now I need to place a dot operator. This production have come from this augmented production. So because of augmented production, nothing more you need to remember. Augmented production, whenever we are bringing that production alone, we need to include dollar. Now, dot I have placed here, dot followed by non-terminal. See, because of non-terminal, all its productions I have brought here, CC production. Now your question, what would become second component? This C is derived from the non-augmented production or original CFG. This is given in the original CFG. So that now I have the freedom to use the first computation symbols. My first computation for capital C is available here. So that I am looking at that. Similarly, this C, because of this C only, another production also have brought, dot D. So these are all terminal, no more action. The second component is also C and D. Because this C is obtained from this production, S produces dot CC. So that I have the freedom to place first off whatever we have seen or obtained. So this is the procedure. I did a recap. Let us go for I1, next state. Now, second component, no need to worry, no more second component. Because whatever we did in the I0 state only going to repeat. So only for this time I'm writing second component, next onwards I don't write. Let us see what is happening here. Now, same procedure. In the SLR, what we will do? We will scan this dot operator or we will cross the symbol capital S. We need to move here. Whenever we are moving here, what we supposed to do? Let us see. If you place this, only one S is available. No more other component. With the dot S combination, we have only one S. So that I need to copy or I need to use this production alone. This dot operator, I need to shift to here. No other duty for us. Simple action, the dot is moved out to the right hand side. Whatever the second component that I need to retain as such. This is called I1 state. Look at here. S dash, S dot, comma, dollar. That dot is moved. Let us go to the second step. Now I can say it as I2, another state or canonical set or closure set. Now what for I need to look at? I need to look at next production. So far now we did this duty. Now we need to go for shifting this dot operator right of the capital C. When I do that, what will happen is your question. I need to copy or I need to consider all the productions which are all having dot capital C combination. Look at this. In this grammar, dot C combination is available only in this production. So that I need to move here. This dot operator, I need to shift here. Could you get my point? I am shifting this dot operator next to the first C. The moment I shift dot operator next to the first C, what I supposed to do is the question. I need to bring all the derivatives of C. all the productions associated with the sea. That is what our duty. So I am bringing these are all the productions from the original grammar. So these are all the two productions available. As original grammar only I need to bring. So I need to place this dot, dot followed by terminal, no more duty for me, dot followed by terminal, no more duty for me. Now you would ask question, what is the second component of this production? The second component of this production would become same dollar, because this production we have brought because of this included production, so that we need to include same dollar. Second component would become same dollar. This is what I do. C dot C comma dollar, because of the mother production or origin. The origin production which has dollar, that is the productions or that is the combinations we are trying to write. Dot C dot C. So with that, let me stop at here. The rest of all other canonical set we can compute in the second subsequent session. There is no more change. We need to work on only the second component. Rest all would be same. No other combinations we need to learn. Only the second component becomes new. Augmented production, numbering the production, shifting the operator, state number, everything would become same as such SLR parser. Let us continue the same LALR parser in the one more class so that you can understand. First, since it is first problem, I want to go slowly so that you can understand better. After LALR, if you wish, I can solve one more problem. If not, we go for CLR.